20-minute drive north of downtown Dallas at Children's Health Star Center Arena. We'll wrap up group play with a doubleheader today on TSN. Later tonight, it is Canada taking on Belarus. And our feature is Sweden and Latvia. And let's meet your starting goalies, Hugo Haviland, his first action of the tournament. He's son of NHLer Nicholas, who was a Ducks third-round pick back in 1999. He played nine NHL seasons, Ducks, Thrashers, and Devils. And his twin brother, Matthias, is playing on this team. He's a defenseman wearing number 5. And Leonards Leipskis, 6'2", 176 pounds. His first action of the tournament as well. So both these goalies jumping right in. Plays for HS Riga. 3-6-1 record, 313 goals against, 916 save percentage with a shutout back home in 12 games played. So Craig, for Sweden, we heard the panel talk about it. Gonna finish second or third in the group. Latvia playing for some pride, as we're set to drop the puck at center ice, and Dover Nielsen wins it for Sweden. We are underway in Edvardsson, the big defenseman stretching it up to Lucell, the two guys you talked about, and they're on the puck early. Lucell cruising around in the offensive zone. A little too much speed, he lost the puck, and he's got to retreat into his own zone. Thorell's Dukurs in pursuit. Edvardsson ships it near wall, shot back in by Simonovic. So Sweden, your defending champs. They won on home soil in 2019 in Örnsköldsvik in northern Sweden for the very first time. Olsen losing the puck. Chip by Victor Sjöholm. Bouncing to Hasa. Hasa tries to skate it in. And then he gets interrupted. His time and space taken away right at the blue line. Olsen up quickly for Persson. Fired right in front of the Latvian bench behind Leipskis. Thought about playing it, leaves it for Fenjeko. And they throw it into the other corner.
It's a nice play by Fenjeko under pressure just to reverse it back.
And that was slipped high. This is not a very big building. That actually hits the roof as Anders Eriksson, the 51-year-old, he coached the U18 world team back in 2014, had a fourth place finish. He's back behind the bench. Also a three-time coach of the U17 World Hockey Challenge. We saw him in 2019 in Canada as well. Trying to get Sweden back to the medal round in that gold medal game. It was an exciting final, an OT thriller. Lucas Raymond, the hat trick back in 2019 and beating Podkolzin in Russia. As that slap shot from the point didn't get through from Sutter-Monson. Moberg driving play into the corner. That was one of the funnest tournaments, Craig. Pat Building, that was home to the Moto program. Pete Forsberg, the Sedin twins are royalty up in northern Sweden. Where'd you rank that one? You called a lot of them. Where'd you rank that final?
Well, I mean, when a country wins the gold medal in the dramatic fashion that Sweden won it on home ice, I don't know, like, there might be ones as good. I don't know if it gets better, you know, to be able to do what they and do it for the first time in the history of Sweden, which is hard to believe that they had never won a gold medal at the U18. But I don't think those ones can be surpassed. They can be matched, but not surpassed.
It's pretty awesome, too, in that building. About 6,000 fans. It was packed. It was a lot of fun. Great atmosphere as Sjöberg trying to drive in. Östlund. Matthias Haviland, he had to back up. He would have put his teammates in offside as Matthias is the twin brother of the goalie starting, Hugo. Sjöberg shot wide.
I'm going to be interested to see if Matthias Haviland is ready to block shots for his twin brother.
Absolutely.
Well,
that's fun, man.
You know, you put on the big pillows. You know, it's your job to stop. Just curious, something I'm watching for, Brian.
Scouting everything. I love it. Here's Olsen. Pretty good speed through neutral ice. Look at him bring it in. Still on it. And then finally stripped of the puck. As Lazare moves to the left side.
Sweden's going to find out the same thing that Canada realized, is that this Latvian team is really disciplined, their positioning is really good, they have layers of defense, and they're not easy to get around. They're going to have to get the puck behind them in the offensive zone and try to work around below the circles. They're too good in the middle of the ice, they're too good at making sure that if they push you into a spot, you know, the next guy is going to be there to support it.
And there is Oleg Sorokins, his second straight tournament coaching the team. Of course, COVID canceled the 2020 edition. Was supposed to be in Plymouth, Michigan. Won the Division I tournament a couple years ago to qualify for the main events. And as mentioned, their best finish all time as they finished eighth. And played Canada tough as well. They met in the quarterfinal in Northern Sweden that year. Canada winning 3-1, and as we saw in this tournament, another gutsy performance from the Latvians versus Canada.
They're competitive, Brian. They're competitive, and you know they don't have a lot of skill, and so but they find a way to stay in a game and not beat themselves.
Here's Rosen in. Nice kick stop rebound as Hasse following up. Edvinson, the big defenseman. Tied for the second ranking on Bob McKenzie's latest list with Dylan Gunther of Team Canada. We'll see Gunther and company later on tonight. And it sounds like, according to Dave Barr, that Shane Wright will return to the lineup for Team Canada, the captain, so that is great news. Edvinson, nice steal right at the blue line. Sweden coming in numbers. They'll send it across. Pearson shoots. Edvinson tries to follow up. And the puck bouncing behind Leiskis. Good job by Moberg. He'll keep it into the blue line. Moberg, in the heat of the battle, comes to the near corner. Strömgren up for Edvinson. Towards the net, knocked down. Edvinson cutting in, tries to hold the zone. And pops free. Sweden will have to reset. Nearly 5 minutes gone in this opening period. Skudnikos takes a look. He'll dish to his partner, Lazarnoux. Out of the reach of Olsen, he'll backtrack, pick it up behind Havlid, looking for Strömgren. The air zoops, that was picked off. Here comes Strömgren with room in, shoots, scores! Lovely shot, William Strömgren off the turnover. It's 1-0 Sweden.
Well, William Strömgren blocks a shot, got a clear path to the net, and snaps it pretty good past Lavinia. Lipskis, there it is, trying to get the puck through, and you know that's a skill all in of itself. Strömgren makes no mistake, head up and sees where the spot is, just under the pad, under the glove, and no mistake.
That is his first of the tournament. He hails from northern Sweden, Örnsköldsvik, which is where the final was in 2019, his hometown. As the moto program used to be in the SHL, it's the second division now. So
probably a pretty good bet that he was at the games.
No doubt. It was packed. It was a fun atmosphere as Sweden cracks things open here. Elias back to work in the corner for Sweden. With the Trey Kroner, a 1-0 advantage in this game. Sjöholm, wrist shot. Didn't get through, bouncing high to the near boards. Olsen. Looking to work it in deep, flipped down the ice by Petters Poolmaus. Schubert along the boards. Latvia changing behind the play. And that is picked up by Elias. Quick shot and he missed. Following up was Albert Schuberg. Elias couldn't find him as Aho will settle it down. His brother is Sebastian Aho, just not that one. Sebastian was a fourth-round pick of the Islanders back in 2017, a defenseman.
I'm laughing, you know why? He said he's the brother of Sebastian Aho, not that one. The other one.
Well, I think...
I know, because there's been so much I'm laughing. I was trying to think about, like, you know, the, well, he is the brother of Sebastian Aho.
He but is.
Like just a Swedish Sebastian Aho, not the Finnish.
Yeah. But it's funny, you hear a last name like a Sundin or an Aho, and the first question you get when you call this tournament from my buddies back home is, oh yeah, is that a so-and-so or a brother or a cousin or a relation? As you get it all the time.
Two different countries, two different nationalities with Sebastian Aho.
You know what catches me though, like Puljujärvi, born in Sweden, raised in Finland. The Edmonton Oilers young star is Robertson. Into the offensive zone, looks to drop it back.
Another example, see, you know, good play, good drive there by Sweden, but Latvia's in great position to intercept that play.
Shot from Silkovs, and that was the first shot on net by Havelid. Get to record it on the scoreboard as of yet, but there it comes. Rosen nearly in as the stick of Schultz got in the way and broke it up.
But even if that play works, Brian, like if we had an opportunity to go back and look at where all the support was with the other Latvian players, it would have been, you beat the one guy, but you're still one on two against the other group, the next group.
Svednikov sitting up behind his netminder, Livskis. Nearly 8 minutes gone in this first period. Hurston brings it in, drag move, shot, in and out of the glove, rebound! Try and getting back was Leonards Livskis. Pretty nice stop on Ludwig Persson. As the breakaway, William Strömgren has made it 1-0 Sweden.
Wow, what a great flashback, a golden flashback. Lucas Raymond with the hat trick. 1-2, and then when he finishes it in overtime, it's just a great play. Yaroslav Askarov, the Russian goaltender. There it is. An unbelievable performance.
Drafted by the Red Wings. Him and Holtz going in the first round. Askarov in that draft. Rodion Amirov, the Leafs prospect as well. Pumals. Weak shot, got it on that, handled by Havilid. Chats up high. Pumals again. Pretty good shift. Two looks, and Hugo Havilid, his first real test of the hockey game.
Well, that was a really good play. Pumals. A couple of times getting on the puck, spinning around, and then finding that puck in front of the net and forcing Havlid into a really good save.
Otis shoots it in deep, and the goal scorer, Strömgren, from his own zone. Nice little move. Still skating with the puck, and then lost it right there off the turnover. Gives it away. Lundqvist in space. He shoots, and Olsen, a good job, got a stick in the way, and the shot deflecting out of play.
Sweden is getting a penalty for too many men on the ice. Here's the play by Pumals a little bit earlier. He spins around, then he ends up with the puck, and that's a good shot and a good read by Hugo Havlid. You know, following the play and then getting right into position to close down the net.
Hugo is 2022 draft eligible in his first major tournament for Sweden. Pretty cool to play with your twin brother as well. As a discussion with the head coach Anders Eriksson.
Now going back to that 2019 gold medal win for Sweden in Örnsköldsvik, they won the gold medal game 5-4 in overtime. Lucas Raymond with the golden goal and a hat trick. Alexander Olsson also had a goal in that game too. So when you think about the two of their youngest players, star players, you know, they were a year younger than everybody, were instrumental in that victory, scoring four of the five goals in that historic first-time win for Sweden.
And the 2019 draft class too, you had Philip Broberg was on that team as well. We mentioned Pod Colson, Soderstrom going to the Coyotes, Bjorn fought to the Kings. A lot of great names, that's why we love this tournament. What a chance to shine as Sundin using his speed. Cutting in, Sundin, great shot just wide as he was trying to break in shorthanded and strike versus Latvia. Sjöholm laying the body far boards. Latvia still controls, and then the linesman getting tripped up with Peter Pulvalls, and here's Sundin shorthanded the other way. Olsen shoots, and just enough. Levskis got a piece, he made the stop. So the best chances here, shorthanded for Sweden thus far. Is Sweden, the fifth-ranked penalty kill in the tournament, 6-for-8 coming into today. Latvia 2-for-13 on the power play. Their power play hasn't really been clicking. It's ranked 8th in the tournament. Ravinskis leading his team with 2 goals in the tournament. He'll shoot it in. Silkals in the corner, back up top. One-time shot deflected, and a good screen in front from Andre Ravinskis. Wrist shot, Havlid answers the call. Gert still calls the shot from the far boards. Holdis sends it across. Wrist shot in and out of the glove. Bobbled a bit as Nick Svenjenko took the shot. Hugo Havlid makes the save.
So we saw earlier in this shift, the collision that Pumals and the linesmen get mixed up and trip each other up. Unintentional contact.
44 seconds remaining in the penalty for too many men. Three shots in the power play so far for Latvia. As Schulzka steps in and wins the faceoff, he'll go to the front of the net. Hodis sends it across. Once the shot just wide, as Hodis loaded up, couldn't hit the net. Still calls. Chuonskis working far board. Sweden trying to clear. They cannot. Silkals takes the bumper behind from Anton Olsson. As Sweden able to clear. Latvia for this game, by the way, only dressing 19 skaters. You can dress 20 skaters. They have 8 defensemen for this hockey game. Ozerzuk sends it across. That shot. And a good setup, and Havlat, I think, just got a piece with 2 seconds remaining from the blast from number 18, header is Pumals.
Well, Pumals has had a couple of chances, and here's Hodas, a nice pass across on the power play, trying to open up opportunities, and then the shot, and Havlat has to be sharp, but this is a really good play on the move, and Pumals forces Havlat into a really good save.
Sweden, the fourth most penalized team in the tournament. Switzerland had a pretty undisciplined game versus Canada in the group.
Pretty undisciplined?
Well, it was.
You are a kind,
however,
kind person.
Germany is officially the most penalized team in the other group in the tournament, as Rosen is in 1-on-2. Back to 5-on-5, Rosen. And that shot missed by a country mile going into the corner. And a penalty coming up. I think Rosen is going to get it. As he missed on the shot, pardon me, that's Hassa, I think, getting the call. Here are the U18s in Texas.
Find more than you expected with confidence. Find comfort in the small things. Find a new outlook. The Chevrolet Equinox. Find new roads.
Chevrolet employee pricing is back. It's time to get your Chevrolet Equinox at our price. See your dealer or Chevrolet.ca for details.
Discover a world of betting at SpinCasino.net. With all your favorite casino games, including roulette and blackjack, and over 400 amazing slots, including the progressive jackpot slot Mega Moolah. Join now and get the VIP treatment only at SpinCasino.net.
Latvia is really moving well in this game, and draw a penalty here. Noah Hasa gets on the wrong side, and now they're going to have to kill another penalty. And Latvia looked pretty good on the first power play.
Latvia 2-for-14 on the power play in the tournament. Through the midway point of this first period, another opportunity. Hodis shoots, and a good stop, big rebound from Havlat, but he makes the initial save. Benjeko into the slot area, backhand knocked down as Jonskis tried to get it on net. Sweden able to clear.
Magnus Hodas has made a really number of good plays here with the puck on the power play, backhand, forehand. Really good poise, and that's, you know, again, we talk about, you know, there's not a lot of high-end skill, if any, on the Latvian team. They have some skill, but Hodas is one of those players that's going to be able to make some plays and get on the power play. This is where you have to try to take advantage if you're Latvia. Tell you what, Brian, through 11 minutes and 4 seconds, Latvia's looked really good.
They come at you, they're physical, they play hard, and they have that competitive fire, as we saw versus Canada. As Martins Lovic driving in, and a hold, so another penalty.
The speed and the pace of Latvia. Again, they draw another penalty because they're moving, and they're getting the puck on the move and pushing through it. They're clear, it's latch on with the right arm. And when you end up on the wrong side, you get yourself into a position where you're kind of grasping and you're trying to get yourself back into the play, and you reach out and now for a minute 25, a 5-on-3. What an opportunity for Latvia.
Elias Salomonsson in the box for the hold. 5-on-3 time as Latvia looks to get set up. Pumal sends it down low. He'll get it back. Whiffed on the pass, but Ozolinch able to recover. He's on the puck. Ozolinch walking in and waiting. Shoots, knocked out in front. Rebound, scramble. Sjöholm chipping for it high and out of play. So the faceoff should remain in Sweden territory.
5-on-3, come on, get the pace up, get moving that puck quicker. You know, when you're moving slow and you're not really making a team have to adjust to your speed and pace, they're able to do exactly what just happened. Get on the puck, stick on a puck, get into the shooting lane.
Martin Zlovic, the captain on the draw, zip back, and to your point, that's what Dave Barr talked about with Team Canada. Slow to start the power play versus Switzerland, not crisp, not moving the puck quickly. They started doing that, and bang, they scored 5 power play goals versus the Swiss. As Permals in, shoots into the crest and held right in the Trey Kroner jersey of Hugo Haviland.
What a presence Permals has been here in the first 12 minutes of the first period. Again, here's the Latvians moving, and then get the puck on the move where you can back up defenders. Here's an example when you're moving quickly. Now, there's no chance for Olsen to get a stick on that puck and deny it over the boards. Havel's going to have to make a save there because you're attacking with speed and pace.
Pullman's plays at HS Riga back home, his second full season in the Tibet League, the top league. Back home in Latvia, Ozolinch controls. He'll send it across. Seam pass didn't work out.
That's a good play by Pumals. I've mentioned this before. You have to pass the puck like that. If you feather it across, it's going to get intercepted. Sometimes the puck skips, but it's on the person, on the player receiving the puck. You got to wire that pass.
19 seconds remaining in the 5-on-3. Fenjako, Ozolinch. He'll switch spots with Fenjako. Ozolinch. Fenjako hesitates for his shot. Might have went wide regardless. Glove down by Haviland. Just 9 seconds remaining in the 5-on-3.
Yeah, you're right, Brian. I think that, you know, Haviland just trying to get things settled down here. Gets a stoppage, but it was a shot that looked like it was terribly dangerous.
Robert Chanunskis, who's played his hockey in Switzerland since 2016, on the draw. Latvia controls, running out of time. Hodis, his shot, a good block in front, bounces back to him in the corner. Matthias Haviland knocked it down. Favorable bounce right in the neutral zone and all the way down the ice. So now 27 seconds remaining. As Latvia still has a chance here to try to get something going. Just over 7 minutes remaining in this first period. Fenjako stretches it up, still calls. Drops it back, Silkals gets the pass back. Ravinskis works it back up to the point. 5 seconds remaining in the penalty. Wrist shot, knocked down in front. And Sweden, a good job to clear so they get away unscathed on the 5-on-3, and Latvia unable to take advantage. 4 shots. But nothing doing as Hugo Haviland has answered the bell here in the first period.
That's where Latvia has to take advantage, though. Those types of opportunities, 5-on-3 for a minute and 25 seconds, you don't have enough skill to let those opportunities go by without making good on them.
Pearson trying to work the give and go. Hasa. Puck by him. Edmondson absorbs the body check. Shoots it along the boards. Schultz had it, lost it, got it back, and able to clear the zone for Latvia. Martin Schultz, he gets taken down right in front of the Swedish bench. And right back to center ice. Lazarenuk starts the play. Denbergs hit at the blue line. Pearson able to control for Sweden. Obviously, the power play time helped, but the shot's 11-6 in favor of Latvia. Robertson got a stick in the way. Lucell spinning around as both Lucell and Edvinsson spending some time in the SHL this year back home in Sweden, the top league. Wrap around, try right through the crease. No one home to tap it away as, again, Petters Pumals has been an impressive player for Latvia in this first period. Lucell trying to wind up his speed. Takes the physical shot at the blue line. Robertson, little chip for Lucell in the corner. Lucell protecting the puck. Looking to cycle it back in. Leuchtmills up the left wing. Leuchtmills, he's taken away by Sjöholm with the puck. Latvia trying to strike again quickly. Wrist shot, good stop. Quick release from Reiners Dardzic. And Haviland the stop. And that's the tough thing for a nation like Latvia, having those finishers, the guys that can score, the natural born scorers. Martins Zirkles is the all-time Latvian top scorer in a single tournament back in 2015. 3 goals, 9 points. That was back in Switzerland when Zug hosted the tournament. Here's Edvinson, receives the pass, trying to make moves through the slot. Strömgren in the corner, shuffles it through his legs. Sundin, he gets taken down below the goal line. 4 minutes remaining in this first period. Sweden a 1-0 advantage on the turnover and goal from Strömgren. Strömgren again on cue. Curls around, waits for help. He takes a look. His teammates were changing, so he'll shuffle it in deep and join them. Schoberg spinning away, works it down low. Ilias tracks towards the front of the net. Ilias in front, jamming away. Couldn't get a good shot away. Good steal, drop pass. Ilias shoots, and that was deflected high and wide as Ilias, dangerous chance right in the slot for Sweden.
So I was talking about Sweden earlier. Where did they work that play from? Below the circles. Turn them around, now it opens up the middle. Latvia is too good in their positional play and their positional discipline if you try to go back or laterally against them. But when you work it from below on them, you're going to have a better opportunity.
Simon Aho to his defensive partner for this game, Anton Olsson. Back to Aho. Sweden completing a change as the two defensemen play pass and eventually work it in deep.
Pretty good chance, and again, working the puck from below, and then the puck comes right up to the stick of Ilias and wires it, but over the net. Good play by Schoberg. He's such a hard-working player. He's disruptive with his speed, real good intensity. Determined, doesn't let himself get denied, and scoring chance gets created there.
Martins Lovic on the draw, those feet and those controls. Held in, Hasa picks up the puck far boards, advancing it to Persson. Persson right at the blue line, it pops loose. Lovic, nice move around his man. Lovic driving into the forehand, he took it all the way to the crease and then taken down. Couldn't get a good shot away on Haviland, but a good effort nonetheless from the Latvian captain. Persson sends it across. Rosen, backhand try, and that was wide.
Isaac Rosen, who gets the puck. Now, you talk about high-end skill. You got gifted one chance. You know, there's Isaac Rosen that gets a chance here. It could have been 2-0. We see one at the other end by Latvia. It's not nearly as easy.
And again, that low ceiling. You can see parts of the roof actually coming down on the ice here at Children's Health Star Center Arena. As we are in Texas for this year's Under-18 World Hockey Championship. This is our final night in this building. We'll move to Frisco for the quarterfinals in the medal round. Wrist shot tipped. Haviland makes the stop, and lurking in front, Julinskis searching for that rebound as Lucell couldn't accept the pass cleanly off his skate down the ice, and that'll be icing.
Gotta love it. Soroka hasn't stopped coaching. No, really emphasizing his team and his. Doesn't matter. It's one line, next line, next line, next line. They really play as a group. Play well.
He played in 7 IIHF World Championships for Latvia, the Olympics in 2002 as well as a player. And now mentoring these young men. here at the U18s. Penyako sends it up by Slovinski. Takes it into the corner, minute 30 remaining in this first period. Back up top, Lucel nearly broke up the play. Weak backhand, and seeing it the whole way was Hugo Havilid. As the shots now 12-6 in favor of Latvia.
Simon Edvinson shows off his skating. He's just so good with that skating. But the Latvians stay right on him, and then they create a turnover, and the backhand comes in, and you know, the effort in trying to get the puck directed towards the net. But for Havilid, that was one of his easier stops of the period.
Victor Sjöholm up for Strömgren. The lone goal scorer in this hockey game thus far, Sundin, penetrating on the forecheck. Latvia able to clear as Dorkers chipped it up just enough. Nice pass by Lovic through the legs. Strömgren through center ice, has a look, he'll dump it in. Final minute, Children's Health Star Center Arena, 1-0 Sweden. As it's the final day of group play here at the Under-18 World Hockey Championship. Scott Salmon, Hockey Canada, will join us in the intermission to talk the Women's Worlds. Great news as the IIHF Women's Worlds is back on. It'll be in late August. Location to be determined. We'll chat that in the U18s, of course. Exciting tournament for Canada. A lot of talent as Canada. Chance to put the bow on it. Great round of group play tonight versus Belarus. As Laura Dykin, Dave Poulin standing by with your intermission and a little rise of temperature after the stop from Hugo Havilid.
So in the game versus Canada, Latvia played a terrific game, and you know, Mason McTavish in a 3-2 game ends up and is cementing it right here on that goal. And then at the end, Meshjargs, the Latvians, you know, the significant disappointment, but all I can say is hold your heads high. Played an excellent game.
He stopped 48 of 52 shots in that 4-2 loss. Played his heart out, literally. And it matters to these young men. Obviously, you see the emotion on their faces as they played Canada very tough, and they earned a lot of respect from the Canadian players as well as Ravinsky's face. Shoots! Rebound available. As he's got two goals in the tournament, looking for his third.
If you were tuning into this game and you didn't know anything about either team, you would say that Latvia is the team going on to the next round and like look really good. I mean, they've carried this whole first period. And if it hasn't been for Hugo Havilid, they'd be up maybe by two or three goals. He's been challenged at different points. But Latvia has thoroughly outplayed Sweden in this first period.
Carl Lindboom has really been the guy. He's backing up Havilid for this hockey game, but he's really carried the load. He got the start versus Canada, and Canada obviously pumped him 12-1, got pulled in that hockey game. But you're right, Hugo Havilid, he has been strong as he made 13 stops in the opening 20 minutes. As William Strömgren, he broke in and he scored the only goal in this hockey game thus far. As it is our final night of group play, Group A at the Under-18 World Hockey Championship, your intermission. Glad you're watching our coverage from Plano, Texas. Your first period scoring summary, just the lone goal as William Strömgren scoring unassisted. He broke in, and you see the shots, Latvia leading in that department, but Sweden a 1-0 advantage. Brian Mucher, Craig Button with you, an all-time at this tournament. Sweden, 10 medals. Their first gold was in Sweden in 2019. Latvia has never medaled, but the one thing you can count on, they always play tough, they play hard, and two players caught your eye in the opening 20.
Yeah, no question about it. The defenseman, Bogdan Hodas, really good with the puck, decisive, making plays on his backhand, making plays on his forehand, and when you're trying to create some opportunities, you need that type of play from your defenseman. Also very good at moving the puck up the ice. There he is getting some instruction. And then Petters Kumas was so good in that first period. He was big, he was hard, he was on the puck, he made plays. He was a dangerous player. So as I mentioned at the end of the first period, Latvia totally dominated that period.
Kumas, Hodas, both with an assist each in the tournament, both looking for their first goals. As Oselinch finds the puck, he'll shoot it in. Edvinson, the big defenseman, works it back, and Sweden in control, moving it up ice. As the goalies are both making their tournament debuts, and that stop from Lipskis.
Couple of Kevins there, Kevin Adams of the Buffalo Sabres, the general manager. To his left is Kevin Devine, longtime scout with the Buffalo Sabres. So they're going to have a high pick, so probably bet that they're watching anybody that has been rated very highly.
Havlid right on, rebound available as Lipskis makes the stop. Come back in by Anton Olsson. Harrison picks it up in the corner. Stretch up the right side, Lloyd Schmills. He lost the puck, it's back and forth. Noah Hassel waiting for help. He'll collect it, bring it to the near wall. He gets dumped. And up the left side, it's Dan Lutschmills towards the net. Grazing Pavlid, easy stop. Skudnikos keeps it alive. Edward Pearson kind of hesitated, fumbled the puck right at the blue line. Dumped right back in by Skudnikos. It's a little choppy to start this second period. As Anders Eriksson was the assistant coach at the IIHF World Juniors in Edmonton under the bubble as well. As Anders is back as head coach, we saw him in 2014, his first time at the U18s.
Thomas Montan, who is here, the head coach of the World Junior team, contacted COVID, so he was unable to come to the World Junior tournament. So one of the things they have to do.
Moberg Sundin, that shot, and getting in the way just in time was Artem Skudnikos as it deflects out of play.
That's closing. Get in there quickly, close the play. Simon Edvinson. Just quickly back to Sweden at the World Junior Tournament. So Thomas Montan, who wasn't able to come because of COVID, you know, and then, you know, they had to, you know, kind of piecemeal the coaching staff and just people that didn't have a chance. But I can tell you this. They talked about how tremendous Lucas Raymond and Alexander Holtz were with the coaching staff, and kind of being coaches from a playing point of view, you know, just working with the coaches all the time, being a voice to the players. So we talked about Holtz and Raymond, you know, as top end players, the fourth and eighth picks, seventh picks in the 2020 draft. And, you know, we know how promising they are. We know how important they were to Sweden winning the U18 gold medal in 2019. But, you know, Sweden didn't have success at the World Junior, but those two youngsters were real, real key players and leaders for that group under very trying circumstances.
You know, we interviewed Ron Francis, general manager of Seattle Kraken, and I asked him what he looks for in players, and character was the first thing he brought up. And obviously, the story you just told screams two guys with character. That will be fabulous with their respective teams, the Red Wings and the Devils. Two fabulous young men that we got to see in northern Sweden. As Gorker is pushed off the puck, Sweden controls. Sjoberg sends it across, Rosen drives it over the blue line, towards the net, chipped right in front, and good job going right to the net was Albert Sjoberg. As Lennard's Lipskis, pretty good stop here in the second.
Well, Sjoberg starts the play through the middle, and then Rosen right to the net. And there's Sjoberg right there trying to create an opportunity, maybe off a deflection or a rebound.
Top line over for Sweden, Lucell, Dover Nilsson, Robertson. Picked off though, and Chanuskis with space gets dumped. And getting back in time was Settlemonson. As Chanuskis nearly broke in on Hugo Haviland. Two on two quickly the other way. Robertson, Lucell. Robertson shoots, and just a piece from Lipskis.
I feel like I should go on the loudspeaker and announce to the Swedish team, do not make passes laterally across the ice. This Latvian team is too good defensively and positionally.
Robertson, his wrist shot wide by a couple of feet. Matthias Havlin chips it in, takes the body check. As he gets back up and some pushing and shoving behind the play, Robertson involved, he'll head off for a change. Stretched up the ice, nice little drag between type as Stromberg. Moberg accepts the pass, waits. Lucell curls around. Edmondson looking for the pass, able to hold it in to the blue line. Couldn't get it to his forehand. Strömgren did get the puck. And we got a hooking call coming up. So that worked by Sweden. And they'll go on the power play here in the second.
We saw some. Here's Ravinsky is reaching in. No need to get in there with your stick. And now Sweden, who really have not had any significant offensive zone time, haven't been dangerous in the offensive zone. And this is one of those times where you get a gift, 2-minute penalty, opportunity to potentially open it up a little bit with another goal.
And again, the low ceiling, the clearing attempt, it's the roof. It's a unique, it's intimate, it's a tiny little rink, but we've had a blast. It's been a lot of fun, this venue. Here in Plano, Texas, we'll move to Frisco for the quarterfinals. Hosley dropping the draw, protecting it for Latvia. Falls, tries to clear, hit the captain, Dover Nielsen, but Latvia comes away 2-on-2. Lovic driving in. Lovic with space, nearly tuck it up top. Off the side of the bar. Hugo Havlin might have got a piece, but what a great chance, shorthanded. Martin Lovic using his speed to break in. Puck still in the slot area, sticks clanking away. Oslinch holds it in the blue line.
That was a heck of a play by Lovic because he was going one-on-one against Simon Edmondson, and he just got way better leverage than Edmondson and snuck around him. Got the outside of the post, but that's one of the things with big defensemen. You still have to be able to have leverage in terms of your defending.
Rosen, Edmondson. Minute 4 remaining in the power play. Rosen walks in, steps up, and a glove stop. Leipskis made the save. Puck battle behind him. Puck bouncing up high. Edmondson finds it and holds to the blue line. Rosen. Lucell. Stick handling. And a good clear as Oselinch.
There's an example of the skill, though. That was a potential for a 2-on-1 against a tired Swedish team. But just the ability to make that little type of a fine play there prevents an opportunity for him ensuing. But it was one that had a lot of promise.
Rosen, wrist shot. He was looking high, glove side. He missed high and wide. Olsen, big shot blocked in front. Rebound in the slot area. As they dig away for it, Oliver Moberg couldn't pull it to his forehand. Oselinch, good sidestepping move, clears the zone, long shot from distance. And just a second remaining in the penalty. Some good chances on both ends, including a nice shorthanded chance.
Well, here's the play. Alovic right around Edmondson. When I talk about leverage, that's part of the longer, taller player still has to work on being able to get that bend and get leverage, because if an opponent, like you just saw there, gets underneath you, you're in trouble. That's developmental. That's something that any bigger defenseman is going to have to work on. But it's an example of where an opponent can get underneath you and take advantage.
So a second remaining in the penalty.
Jones is saying it's a penalty to Latvia, because it would be a lie to call it a power play for Sweden, because there was no power in it at all.
Collision behind the play, then Sundin goes down, loses his stick. Centering pass, and that's flipped down to neutral ice. Sundin trying to speed in, as Hodes got there first. Anton Olsen dumps it in. Nearly 7 minutes gone in the second period. Just the one goal so far. Strömgren scoring it in the first period.
Off a blocked shot. Breakaway.
Schubert Around the world, still on the puck. Schubert, stick handling. He'll drop it off. Some wants it in. Shoots off a body high and wide. Sonomanson receives the pass in the corner. Works it far boards. Chipped up the ice. Ravinskis couldn't get there in time. Cleared up to Elias Sonomanson. Ilias chips it up. Schoberg cutting into the backhand. He thought about dragging it and took the forehand shot. He was looking to go up top. And Leipskis had the angle covered.
Yeah, Leipskis stayed up on it.
Another shot scores! Just as he made the initial stop, that one squeaked right through the pads. And it was the blast from Albert Schoberg getting through the five hole, and it's 2-0 Sweden.
Well, Sweden got a gift, but Schubert has talked about him in the first period about he skates, he's determined, he's competitive, he's on the puck, and we saw the chance earlier. Here he is just getting himself up a little bit high and gets that shot away very, very quickly through the Latvian defender and then through the legs of Leipskis. Squeaks right through. Well, you hear the goaltenders talk about one they want back. That is clearly right there, picture evidence of one you want back.
So Albert Schoberg, his first of the tournament. Sweden putting up two goals now in the hockey game. Started off the tournament with a 5-1 win over Belarus. Of course, the loss to Canada, 12-1. And then 3-1 over Switzerland. Switzerland had a 1-0 lead in that game. Dave Poulin talked about it. And then there was a 5-minute major and knee penalty as Rosen picks it off, sends it across looking for Pearson. And they scored 3 power play goals in just over 3 minutes during that 5-minute major. And that was the difference. The Swiss actually played a pretty strong hockey game, but special teams ultimately decided that hockey game. Simonovic flips the backhand to neutral ice. Matthias Havlid protecting the puck. Collides, but able to get it in deep. Pass on the forecheck quickly. Whoops. Tripped right over the red line. Tough one for Simonovic, but able to move it up the ice. It happens. Sweden coming in numbers. Rosen. Goes off for a change. Robertson passing it to him, but he got taken down as he was at the tail end of a shift and went off for a change. Weinbergs fires it in, and now Latvia, an entire wholesale change. Lucelle racing after it. Leipskis knocked it down with the blocker. Schultz up the left side. He'll backhand it in. Sjöholm. Back defensively with Olsen. Play below the goal line. Held in by Skudnikos. Controlled by Sweden. As Dover Nielsen, the captain, takes a look. He'll pump it in. And then off to the bench. Sjöholm, good job at cradle the puck. He knocks it down at neutral ice. Allowing Sundin to walk in. Tries to feather across. And a good shot block. Or a pass block, rather. More of a flip across the ice as Finjanko laid out and made sure that pass didn't get across. I think Sundin got a touch on that, and he did.
I'm sure I'm going to get a note from my buddy Steve Koulias. We talk about the elongation defender laying on the ice, and I'm always reminding of him. I don't think it's a good play, but he loves to point out to me when it works. So I'll be expecting that note coming any minute.
And at the very least, you just reminded him. So there you go, as we have an icing call.
Steve doesn't need reminding.
So Sweden a 2-0 advantage, and we know that Sweden cannot win top spot in the group. They will finish second or third. And as we look forward to the quarterfinals and the crossover.
So Sweden's going to play a really good opponent in the quarterfinal. Czech is down 3-0 after the first period to Russia. So they'll finish fourth. So you're going to get a really good opponent. And the way Sweden is playing, that might be their last game in this tournament. They do not look like a team that's capable of competing for a medal.
Wee Krister from Zizovs from the blue line, nowhere near the net. Controlled by Strömgren, using his speed again, cutting in with Sundin. Strömgren able to handle the bouncing puck up for Edvinson. Strömgren goes right to the net. Nice move, Edvinson. Stick handling, lost the puck. Backed up though by Schuberg. Schuberg into the corner, works it below the goal line. Schuberg looking for the pass. Edvinson though is in deep. The defenseman curls around. Edvinson pinned but gets the pass. Schuberg, wrap try, tries to wrap it in. Two chances, jamming. And finally the whistle as Lipskis got across in time and makes the save. Right through the five hole as Schuberg's made it 2-0 Sweden.
You listened to your coach and played like your heroes. But not every game goes your way. From generation to generation, life lessons are passed on. Our moments of understanding and learning connect us. And while some things change, others stay the same. Esso, 80 years supporting hockey.
Discover a world of betting at spincasino.net. With all your favorite casino games, including roulette and blackjack, and over 400 amazing slots, including the progressive jackpot slot Mega Moolah. Join now and get the VIP treatment only at spincasino.net.
So we wrap up Group A play. Obviously, we have Sweden taking on Latvia. We know Sweden will finish second or third later on tonight. It's Canada taking on the Belarusians, and Belarus should be a good opponent tonight for Canada.
I think they will be.
Kumal shoots as he broke in. Simon Aho getting back defensively, trying to take him off the puck. Zlovic couldn't get the puck and drive it towards Havelid. Sweden clear, slipped up. Schuberg leaves it. Back up. Solomonsen, great shot, just wide. Elias couldn't get the stick on it, so he'll dump it off. Schuberg lost the puck. As Petter Pumals plays it back to his defenseman, Simonovic. Sweden changing. Up to Ozilinc. Long stretch pass and out of the reach, nobody home. That is icing. So Canada looking very strong to wrap up officially top spot in Group A. Here is Group B and Finland 8 points. And this is as of right now, obviously, Craig, with games ongoing.
It is. Russia's up 4-0. So Russia's going to finish first or second, depending on the outcome of the United States-Finland game. Finland needs only 1 point to finish in first place. With Russia winning the game, USA cannot pass Russia. So, well, the first one and two, I mean, very interesting as tournament play goes on.
Person turnover, weak wrist shot. And it was deflected, knocked away in time, didn't get through to Lipskis.
We've talked a lot, and rightfully so, about Shane Wright, who's only played one game in the tournament, and certainly Connor Bedard, but they have two equals in Russia. Ivan Marashnichenko and Matvey Mishkov, who scored his seventh goal, leading the tournament in goal scoring. He's eligible for the 2023 draft, like Connor Bedard. Marashnichenko is eligible for the 2022 draft with Shane Wright, and they are elite top-end players.
Do you remember a tournament, Craig, where so many underagers are sort of the stars for their respective teams? Quite a few that you talked about just right there.
Well, I don't know if I do or I don't. I'd have to go back and look at it. There's always good underage players in this tournament.
Some bodies flying in our feature matchup. Right at the blue line. As the under-18s continue here on TSN.
Why can't paying bills pay you back?
What?
We think paying bills should feel less like this and more like this. So we gave 1,000 PC Optimum points per bill payment. Feels good, right? The PC Money Account, a whole new way to think about money.
The world needs more friendly. With TELUS, friendly means becoming part of something bigger. Using technology for good will help make our world a better place. So let's make the future friendly, together.
Who says payday can't have more payoff?
That would be nice.
We want that for you, too. So we added a welcome bonus. 25,000 points when you set a payroll deposit. So you get a little extra just for getting paid. The PC Money Account, a whole new way to think about money.
And welcome back to our coverage. So the IIHF Under 18 World Championship medals all time. And Sweden, a total of 10. Canada, 7. And the United States always simply dominates this tournament, as they've medaled in 16 straight tournaments, which is pretty impressive for the United States and the United States National Team Development Program in Michigan.
You know, just as I'm looking at that and I'm thinking back, 2019 U18, you ask me about young players, Raymond and Holtz. 2015, Matthews and Kachuk. Key top-end players for their teams en route to gold medals.
Here's Robertson in the offensive zone through the slot. Works it down low. Lucell collects it in the corner. Edvinson hesitates, shoots, hits a stick, and goes into the corner. Salomonsson through traffic. Big screen in front of Lipskis. Lucell circling around. Crafty little skater in the offensive zone. Gets the pass back. As Moberg got dumped, Lucell's turn. He gets knocked over as well. And a penalty coming up. And there you see it's Lucell on the ice. Edvinson trying to stick up for his teammate.
Zaitsev is a big... I think it was Zaitsev that got it. Kind of close quarter contact, close quarter battles. So the play on Lucell knocks him down again. It's... I don't know what the penalty is, to be honest with you.
That stick slash right at the very end. I think he's already down, and then that whack at the very end. So Vladimir Zaitsev's in the penalty box, and Sweden back on the power play. Olsen, one-timer, and that's done. Big shot block. Olsen again loads up into the glove, and still smarting his better pool balls, who's trying to shake it off right now. And he's going off to the bench.
He's been really good offensively. He's a big player, and there he is now, turning around to block the shot. Never easy to block the shot, a little less protection when you turn around that way, but committed.
Lovic and Elias to take the draw. Nice win from Lovic and shot down the ice by Latvia. Pavlid leaves it for Olsen. Sweden turns it up ice, turnover at neutral ice. Good job by Latvia, back to Hodis. He'll hesitate, wait, and then dump it in. Here, turnover right and tight as Lovic was trying to create again, shorthanded. And a penalty behind the play, and they're going to call it. And that was good work from Lovic on the penalty kill as he draws a penalty. It's like Anton Olsen going to the box.
Olsen tries to make a play, and it wasn't a penalty on that play. Then they get kind of a little bit collided. I think that part about the
falling on the top of Lovic's head is what's going to get him to the penalty box.
So we'll have 4-on-4 for a minute 21. As Latvia needing a spark here, Craig, got to try find a way to generate something, some traffic, an ugly one, whatever. Get some momentum going and try to beat Hugo Haviland here in this contest. Lojc Mills on the draw. Sam Monson picks it up behind his goalie. So some extra space on the ice. Under 6 minutes to go in this second period. Sjöholm. Strömgren. Weaving in. Nice move. Strömgren all the way into the forehand. He nearly went coast to coast as Strömgren looking for his second of the game.
It was interesting as he was moving. He kind of said, oh, I'll take that space. I'll take that next space. And then the space just kept presenting itself. And he just kept going until he was right there and close on the net. Pretty good opportunity.
Nearly danced all the way in. Fun to watch on Leipskis. Haviland. Sjöholm. Little chip tries to move it up ice. As Van Berks on the forecheck. Lucille had the speed, couldn't bring the puck with him. Odas assesses things and he'll dump it in the corner. He'll offer a change. Just 8 seconds remaining in the 4-on-4. Dover Nielsen looks up for Lucille, using his speed. Lucille, as he falls, caught an edge. Seen that a few times with the ice as he blew a tire and fell down, couldn't get the shot away. So 30 seconds now of power play time as Leipskis thought about playing it, but a little bit too late as the whistle had already been blown. So 28 seconds now of power play time for Latvia. Leading in the shots department, 21-17. Sweden the leading where it hurts, up 2-0 in the hockey game.
Couple of breaks. We saw Strömgren get it with the block shot, then the breakaway, and then we saw Schulberg, you know, just quickly getting the puck through that skips through the legs of Leipskis.
Pulmals driving in with speed, takes it behind the net. Absorbs the body check. Edvinson in the corner. 10 seconds remaining. Weak shot. Haviland handles that, no problem. Edvinson using his big 6'4" frame in the corner. Back to 5-on-5 hockey. Rosen was looking for the stretch pass to break in. It was intercepted right at the blue line, and that's out of the reach of the captain, Martin Lovic. So icing the call. Coverage of the Men's Under 18 World Hockey Championship keeps on rolling tonight. Team Canada continuing their quest for gold against Belarus. Puck drop, 9 p.m. Eastern Time, 6 p.m. Pacific, only on TSN. As Craig Button and myself, Brian Mudrick, will have the call. Laura Dykin, Dave Poulin, doing a great job hosting back in studio. Sweden controls. Quick shot, and that had a little bit of sauce on it from Anton Olsson. But Leipskis able to hold it down. Oh, man, how good does that look? World-class barbecue down here in Texas.
It isn't about escaping life. It's about finding it.
Find more than you expected with confidence. Find comfort in the small things. Find a new outlook. The Chevrolet Equinox. Find new roads.
Chevrolet employee pricing is back. It's time to get your Chevrolet Equinox at our price. See your dealer or Chevrolet.ca for details.
Subway introduces new potato bun sidekicks. Soft potato buns made with Canadian potatoes, stacked with quality ingredients. New potato bun sidekicks, starting at $2.99, only at Subway.
Cheer on Team Canada in style with the newest Nike Team Canada Heritage jersey. There's something for everyone at Hockey Canada's official online store. And you can visit shop.hockeycanada.ca to get all of your gear. Canada-Belarus later on this evening. Under 4 minutes to go in this second period. Latvia-Sweden. And a goal per period so far for the Swedish side as they lead. Fanning on the shot was Ravinskis. Couldn't get it through. And Sweden quickly in transition. Pearson drops. Rosen, wrist shot off the post. Rosen using his speed, and he labeled the crossbar. Isaac Rosen, what a great shot. That close to his third goal of the tournament.
Well, he can shoot the puck, and he's got an excellent release. Oh, the ability to disguise the puck and not let the goaltender get a read on it. And the worst sound for a goal scorer is pipe. The best sound for goaltender is pipe.
Unless it's pipe far down and in, then it's a good, if you're the goal scorer, feel scared. Just saying.
Yeah, you're right.
You know, good goal. I'm right once a tournament, so I don't want to waste it too early. Lucelle right on Lipskis. As young Isaac Rosen, Bob McKenzie has him ranked 23rd on his most recent list. As Leonard Lipskis getting a chance to shine in his first action of the tournament. Same for Hugo Haviland. Hugo is 2022 draft eligible. And I haven't seen his brother block shots for him yet, Craig, but we're watching for the Matthias Haviland block shot for Hugo Haviland.
I just think as a twin, you know, you're kind of, you know, in sync, you know, help him out. But he's been good. Hugo Haviland's been really good in that net.
I'm just trying to think of other hockey twins. Obviously, Henrik Lundqvist and Joel Lundqvist. And I mean, you could walk down the street and you think one was the other. Obviously, that's why they're twins, clearly.
Identical twins.
Yeah.
But I always used to bug Joel when they named Henrik as one of the 50 most beautiful athletes in the world. He says, why am I not on that list? We're identical looking.
Yeah, he's got to be. I mean, right? That's awesome.
What a career Joel's had, too. And the Swedish Hockey League with Sweden internationally. Just unbelievable career with Frölunda. Just unbelievable. And we know what Henrik has done in his career. Hall of Famer, for sure, in my view.
Well, we got to stop it here, Craig. Tee up Canada-Belarus tonight for us.
Well, Belarus has more skill than Latvia. They're good size and they can skate, and they're going to pose a good challenge for Canada. Now, that game when they lost to Sweden 5-1, it was really a 3-1 game until late when Sweden scored a couple of goals.
Simon Edvinson bringing it in deep, still with the puck.
And I better not hear one Canadian player say, oh, we took them lightly.
Edvinson still on it. Good puck possession in front. Oh, he had Strömgren teed up for a second of the game. I don't think Strömgren was ready for the pass. Good job by the big defenseman down low, Edvinson. And the creativity, and he slung it through. That one does not hit the roof. Stays in play. Edvinson just avoiding the collision, but they're going to blow that down immediately as Claus Vanbergs.
I don't think he caught him, did he?
Well,
maybe he did.
The refs feel that way, and look at Edvinson does not look good. My goodness.
My perch here, I thought Edvinson had avoided him, but
he is. No, it was, and he took a knee-on-knee hit in the Switzerland game, and he was okay.
That was the five-minute major.
Yeah, and they called it instantly, Craig, and he was limping literally to the bench.
Oh yeah. Oh, geez. I don't know how I missed that, but I completely missed it. Yeah, that's that's a five-minute major. There's no question about it. Has to be.
And he's getting some attention.
I thought Edmondson had kind of leaped him, but certainly not the case. And now you just hope that Simon Edmondson is going to be okay. Now that's a... Oh, boy. Ooh.
And he's 6'5", 207 pounds, and... Never want to see a play like that ever on the ice.
No, you don't.
Ever.
And, you know, we can talk about intent and, you know, the type of play. That's where you, I put the onus on the player delivering the hit. You got to slow down. And when those types of plays, yeah, we go, it's unfortunate, it's a bad result. No, it's a result of a player being out of control. And that's where the game has to get slowed down and players have to be held fully accountable for that type of play. Yeah, it's unfortunate. Unfortunately, it was the player's own reckless play that caused it. No excuse for it.
Now you see him on the bench, and great job by our crew here. Yeah.
It
in
looked
Texas.
Like it looked like it might have got him below the knee, more on the shin part, which would be the good news. Like I said, I completely missed it as he was coming up. I thought he had avoided the check, but not the case.
So he's trying to shake it off, and let's hope he is okay. Obviously one of the big pieces for Sweden, one of their stars on this team on the back end. So a five-minute major and a chance for Sweden to really crack things open in this hockey game. Already up 2-0 as Rosen back up top. That shot off of body and wide is Anton Olsen now at the blue line on this power play for Sweden. Rosen. Olsen back to Rosen, right through the slide area, looking for Pearson. Havlik back for Olsen, and a good job as the captain. Lovich finds it and he clears.
Lovich has been impressive offensively without the on the penalty kill. Defensively, really good, solid play from him in all areas.
Wrist shot up high and right on as Olsen. Pretty good zip on the wrist shot. Lipskis though hit him in the crest, and he holds with 25 seconds remaining in the second period.
And there's Simon
that's
Edmondson
awesome.
Skating, trying to get a feel for things. That's just a good sign. It just really is. There's no other way to put it.
And not only testing it, it sounds and looks like he's gonna stay out here. So great news for big number 8, Edmondson, on the ice.
So he took that knee against Switzerland. He had 2 assists on the ensuing 5-minute power play where Sweden essentially won the game.
Good strong stick there. Stops the clearing attempt. Over Nilsson down low. Good swat from Lipskis as he had the poke check going and worked it nicely. Over Nilsson for Edmondson. 7 seconds remaining. High shot, rebound in front, cleared by Latvia as Edmondson able to get a shot from the blue line. So a 2-0 advantage.
Receive a free footrest. Just use the code on your screen. Your new normal, incredibly comfortable. Call or click to order today and receive a 30-day risk-free trial and $100 off.
Welcome back to our coverage at the Under-18 World Hockey Championship. So Sweden a goal in the first, one in the second. And the good news is that Edmondson, we saw that knee-on-knee hit, but he returned for the power play. And so 3 minutes, 51 seconds of power play time to start this third period. Ryan Mudrick joined by Craig Button. And the longtime NHLer, Nicholas Havlett, has to be very proud of his twin boys competing for Sweden in this tournament, especially in this hockey game.
Well, Hugo Havlett, the goaltender, and I'll tell you what, all his teammates should be very proud of him, because without his really good, stellar play, there's no question that Latvia would have a goal or 2 or 3, maybe 4 on the board. He has been really good. He's been really sharp. And he's been tested at different moments and at different times throughout this game. And it's 2-0 for Sweden. And right now, you're looking at the star of the game for Sweden. It's Hugo Havlett. He has been that good for this Swedish team that has been largely outplayed by Latvia. It'll be interesting to see what happens here, you know, with the power play, but it's a chance for Sweden to get some breathing room.
So 2-0 in the hockey game, and we've talked about it numerous times, and of course our panel back at TSN has talked about it as well. Sweden will finish second or third in the group, but a chance to get some work on the power play, get some momentum going for the quarterfinals, no matter who they play. Goal scorers, they like to score goals. They like to feel good about themselves, and this is a great chance to start the third. Here's Olsson. He'll skate it up ice, fire it in. Strömgren chips it along the boards behind the net. Rosen back up top. Havelin. Matthias Havelin. Twin brother of Hugo. Seam pass. And he gets it back. Went through Strömgren. Back up for Olsson. Rosen works it down low. Gets the pass back. Rosen wrist shot. Blocked.
Another post for Isaac Rosen.
Matthias Havelin tried to give and go to work it down low. Right in front, shot scores! Strömgren, power play goal, his second of the game. It's 3-0 Sweden.
Yeah, Strömgren steps into that spot, that sweet spot at the exact right time, and he makes no mistake about it. It's a hard play to defend. You know, you're turned around and everybody's looking below the goal line, and that allows Strömgren to slide in, and the pass is perfect. And it's off his stick as the goaltender turns to try to pick it up. The only thing he's picking out is the puck out of the net.
Interesting, Craig. Came into this game without any points, and he's done nothing but finish in this hockey game. Two nice goals, 3-0 Sweden. And a lot like the game against the Swiss, you get the five-minute major, and it's all about taking the most of that opportunity and burying your chances, and they've done that thus far, and they still got 2 minutes and 48 seconds remaining.
Strömgren didn't play in the first two periods against Belarus, and then he got into some game action in the third period of that game, so clearly, you know, finding his form, and important for Sweden. To find that form.
As Lucell got dumped right at his blue line, able to advance the puck momentarily. Robertson chips it back to Lucell. And then he gets dumped again to the blue line. He's trying to stick handle right into the zone, and that entire line, all five off for a change for Sweden. So fresh troops out on the power play. Still calls in deep. Bouncing puck, couldn't settle it down. Up quickly for Rosen. Throws it in, shoots off the stick and wide. He'll pick it up again. Rosen for Olsson. Back to Rosen. Olsson at the blue line. Whiffing Rosen on the one-timer. Wrist shot into the glove. No traffic in front, so an easy stop is Isaac Rosen. Man, he's really showcased his shot in this hockey game.
Well, here's William Strömgren. He blocks the shot, goes in on the breakaway, just over the pad, under the glove. Picks a spot, and then on the power play, really good play. Moves in at the right time, and picture-perfect pass. An even better finish.
Good face-off win by Latvia. Minute 30 remaining. Kind of a weird bounce that allows Sweden to keep it in. It's Robertson. Then he popped the stick off of Chuonskis. Ravinskis kills off a few more seconds, but a quick strike up for Sundin. Space shoots just wide, looking far side, and Lipskis was cheating a little bit to the near post, and he nearly exposed him.
And you had a pretty good look at it, Brian, where you could see where he was just a little bit off his mark, and it's exactly where Sundin was trying to hit. You know, when that right leg is outside of the post and outside of the blue, you have to know that there's some net open on the far side, and certainly there was. Sundin just missing wide, as you saw.
Arvid Sundin, a goal in the tournament, nearly had his second as Olsson flips it into the corner. Hodis. Able to clear down the ice under a minute remaining. So 3-0, Sweden scoring at least a goal in every period thus far. And a nice one on the power play from Strömgren. Pearson accepts the pass, he'll skate it in. Flips it cross ice. looking for Schuberg. Harrison. Olsson. Pretty shot from Schuholm, and that missed. And offside as Pearson brought it over the blue line. So Sweden will have to change up. Just 8 seconds remaining in the penalty. Pumals right in coast to coast. Got the shot away, and Havilland closed it down. As Pumals, one of the more impressive players for Latvia in this hockey game.
Yes, he has been very impressive, Brian. And even as he's moving up the ice there, I mean, he's moving with real speed and force, and he's a big man. And Schuholm recognizes, maybe I'll just try to defend him in a different way instead of trying to take him head on.
Rundgren, and Hasso on the fourth check. Latvia able to chip at the neutral ice. Rosen collects it, sends it back to Selemonsen. He'll go off for a change.
And so relegation, we'll see Latvia play Germany. Winner stays in the pool, and loser will go down.
Lucelle Robertson. Nearly the tic-tac-toe passing finished off, but Robertson, were they not able to finish, was find the puck and get the shot away as Dover Nilsson had him teed up. Still calls. Drives in by Matthias Havlin. Centering pass in tight and in a good stop as he fouled Ravinskis, and Havlin continues to have a strong game. Lucell speeding in. Lucell back at try late. Oh, good save in front. Rebound. And buried, so the follow-up converted.
Great save by Lipskis on the second, on the first shot. Nice little play by Lucelle, and then Simon Robertson just makes no mistake putting it right in the top part of the net. But here's Lucelle as he's moving in. He does a quick little turn, and then there's the first chance, and there's Robertson. He's not going to miss on those with that much net to look at. Really good pivot here by Lucelle, and then turns around, and then on the backhand, really deft hands. It's a really nice little play. Quick little turn, opens up the seam, and then Robertson all over that rebound after the great save on the first shot by Lipskis. No chance on the second.
So Robertson gets his first of the tournament. His father, Bert, was a defenseman, 123 games in the NHL with the Canucks, Oilers, and Rangers. I was reading some of the scouting reports on him, and I laughed at the one that I read. One scout saying he shoots as hard as a horse kicks. I like it. I've been on a ranch. I grew up on a farm. They kick hard. Got to be careful around horses.
Well, I think, too, with Robertson, though, I mean, you always have to be careful, but he's also got accuracy. You know, there's some horses that kick hard but can't run. They're not going to be in the Kentucky Derby, which is today.
That's true. Here comes Chris Dinge using his legs and his speed. He got on his horse, and now it's Ilias's turn. He'll bring it into the offensive zone. Ilias curls around, up top shot, as Schuholm just whistled it wide. Olsson takes the body check, then he stumbles, losing his footing. As Östlund able to chip it in deep. Schuberg chasing after it. Pumals tries to chip it around his check. Knocked off the puck. As Moberg took it away from him. Lovic tried the centering pass. That was intercepted. Nearly 7 minutes gone in this third period. Ravinskis tried the give and go. Latvia controls. Able to fire it back in. Dorkers. Near boards, and finally Persson able to send it up for Sundin with space. Arvid Sundin in, shoots, big stop. Lipskis keeping Latvia alive. Already it's a weak pulse, down 4-0, but that is a massive save.
Just competing, like, you know, still, you know, doing everything in his power to
play his position and do his part. And Latvia does that. I mean, yeah, they're down 4-0. We saw what happened at the end of the Canada game and the emotion, but they continue to play hard and smart. And I don't want to continue to harp on it, but you know, when you lack the skill, it just becomes harder and harder. Your margin for success is really, really thin when you don't have that skill. But I'm impressed with the way they play.
And not only battle, Craig, too, all of these goalies, all three that Latvia brought, they're all 17-year-olds, so a chance to gain some great experience playing against some top-level teams at this tournament. Garzic had the puck stolen from him.
Well, the big key now for Latvia is to find a way to beat Germany two games. That's the key now.
Well, speaking of ice, coverage of the LGC World Women's Curling Championship continues tonight. Carrie Anderson and Team Canada taking on RCF. And you can watch the action at 9 p.m. Eastern time in the curling bubble in Calgary. And it's Vic Roeder, Cheryl Bernard, Russ Howard will have you covered with all the coverage. Doing a great job in the curling bubble. Rebound to the right of Haviland. Easy stop, he'll cover up. So a 4-0 advantage for Sweden as they strike on the power play. As Strömgren, Robertson making it 4-0.
Find more than you expected with confidence. Find comfort in the small things. Find a new outlook. The Chevrolet Equinox. Find new roads.
Chevrolet employee pricing is back. It's time to get your Chevrolet Equinox at our price. See your dealer or Chevrolet.ca for details.
At JackpotCity.net, we know how to build you the best casino. So you can do amazing things with just one chip. Our table games are honed to perfection. We have over 500 online slot games, all designed for excitement, including the world-renowned progressive jackpot slot Mega Moolah. Play for free at JackpotCity.net today on your tablet, laptop, or mobile. JackpotCity.net. Casino games perfectly made for you.
It obviously is a very proud hockey nation and some outstanding names on this board. And this is in a single tournament. William Nylander, your leader all time. And that was back in 2014, 16 points. Remember being up in Örnsköldsvik, Peter Forsberg, a legend up there, actually owns a golf course up in northern Sweden as well. As Dover Nielsen tracking towards the front of the net. Robertson shoots and scores. What a shot. As Robertson's got his second of the game, it is 5-0. What a rip from Simon Robertson.
How'd you like that kick? And shoot the puck. Him and Isaac Rosen are really good goal scoring. The way they shoot the puck, the way they get into those spots. And they don't need a lot of room to finish. You know, we've seen Rosen hit a couple of posts, but Brian, this is your post in it.
I was ready. Yeah. I was so ready to remind you, like Steve Koulias, I was standing by.
Yeah.
That's awesome.
I'm often reminded how dumb I am, Brian.
Hey.
But one thing I'm not is I'm not stupid.
I never said that.
I didn't say you did.
Because you can't fix the second one. I've been told that. Yeah. You can't fix the second one. What a great shot, though. As Robertson showing off some of his skill with that shot. He's got two in the game. And Sweden up 5-0.
See, I thought the call there should have been giddy up.
Yeah, well, listen, we're both from Alberta and spend time there, and I spent a lot of time on the ranch. So, yeah, horses, they kick hard. I know firsthand. And that young man's got a heck of a shot. So, a nice little story. Good to put a bow on it as well as he comes through with two big goals in the hockey game. Strömgren with a couple as well. And we talked about it. I don't think you can ever stress enough. You know, goal scorers, they love to find the back of the net. They love that bar down and maybe some extra swagger and confidence for this Swedish team going into the quarters as Sundin brings it in. He shoots again, misses wide glove side. And worth noting as well that no big number eight, no Edmondson that I've seen in the third period. He tried to test it out, obviously, at the end of the second, a few moments on the five-minute major on the power play. So let's just hope that he is okay. It did not look great initially. Tabler looking for Pearson, stripped by Kristic, controlled by Latvia up the right side. As Lorch Mills couldn't settle it down. Matthias Havlik starts it up ice. Moberg up the right side, hesitates, stops, waits for help. He'll backhand it in for Pearson. Chips high, Pearson, good vision. He finds the puck first, then he falls. Takes a spill in the battle with Studnikos. Ravinskis, it was in his skates, but Rosen found where the puck was, and he's on it right now for Sweden. Trying to chip and chase up the ice with his line mate Hasa. Rosen holds it at the blue line. Just avoids the body check. And as I say that, he got pushed down, gets back up. And as the grind continues for this line, Hasa into the corner. Olsen was looking for the pass. A little too much heat. It was behind him. Good collision in front of us. Silkalls takes the shot, then gets it to Ravinskis, and Ravinskis stopped by Hugo Haviland. And the boys on the bus, they've arrived. Live look at Team Canada. Ready to roll. They'll take on Belarus later on tonight here at Children's Health Star Center Arena. Their final group game right here on TSN.
It's not magic. Even the greatest magicians worked at that trick. We give our blood, sweat, and tears to be our very best. Even when the world tells us it's never going to be enough. We got that thing. Nah, baby, this ain't magic. This is the real thing.
I'm in. As in a community of players, one shared passion. In. Whatever you're playing, whoever you're playing with, there's always a seat at the table. Play PokerStars.net for free.
Subway introduces new potato bun sidekicks. Soft potato buns made with Canadian potatoes. Stacked with quality ingredients. New potato bun sidekicks starting at $2.99 only at Subway.
The two captains, Lovich and Dover Nielsen, ready to line up for the face-off to the left of Hugo Haviland, who has just been, he's been solid. He's made some nice stops. I mean, Latvia, as you talked about, they just don't have that high-end skill or the finishers to try get one by him, like we've seen out of Robertson or Strömgren, obviously, has had a couple of nice goals in the hockey game as well. Lucella guy I've enjoyed watching. Big collision right at center ice as Simon Aho got tangled up. He looks to be fine, Lucelle.
Simon Aho only gave up about 8 inches and about 80 pounds in that collision.
Sometimes it's the size of the fight in the horse, too, as a good job. Salomonsson got back and tied up his man and then finishes the body check on Darzic in the corner. Lovich also playing physical in the offensive zone. Robertson picks it up, and he'll skate it in himself. Robertson tried to tuck that in high, short side, and he didn't miss by much for the hat-trick goal.
The shooters, we talked about this before.
Look out, space, Oslin in, shoots, kick stop that time. Lipskis got it.
The good shooters, the players now.
Ravinskis, space, kicks it to his stick, backhand, stop. The best of the game from Hugo Haviland as Ravinskis looks skyward. What a great chance. He'll chip it in front, side of the net. Loose puck available. And no one from Latvia able to capitalize as Ravinskis nearly had one. Weak shot from Anderson that missed, and finally Haviland finds it. He'll hold. Pretty good little burst, actually. Good chances at both ends, but that was the best save of the game for Hugo Haviland.
Well, Oslin gets a real good chance here, and a real good save by Lipskis, and then coming right back is Ravinskis, and Haviland right through the middle here and kicks it to himself, and then a nice stick. playing right with him, Havlat. Like he's not guessing, he's moving there. Really, Ravinskis didn't have anywhere to put that puck.
Dans Vojtmils takes the draw. He's played in Sweden the last few seasons. Representing Latvia. As Asplund circle spins, gets it to his partner, and look out, here comes Sweden again. Sundin hits one person, shot it, and just wide. I think Leafskis got a touch. He was moving from his left to his right, going the other way, and he just couldn't finish, but he had a good opportunity, did a Ludwig Pearson.
Nice pass by Sundin, who showed off some really good skating and speed in the game, getting open, but he makes the pass across to Pearson, and he's had some impact in this game, Sundin, with that skating ability.
Oliver Moberg getting set with Martin Lovic. Lovic has been really good in the faceoff circle tonight for Latvia.
He's a good all-round player, really is. Smart and competitive, makes plays, like plays in all the situations.
And he's one on three, and he takes the body check. A big hit right in front of the Swedish bench, and a tough kid too as he absorbs the hit from Sjöholm. Moberg, Sundin. Got to get it back to Moberg, tracking towards the net. Moberg takes the hit from Lovic. That shot just missing high, and it was Simon Aho stepping into one. Moberg again below the goal line. Pops right free in front. Holmgren couldn't get the shot away. He'll backdrop it. Aho shoots. Oh, tough block in front, and that stung. Sweden controls. Strömberg spins, and again it's Lovic who blocked that right in front again, and he's hobbling.
How about the play Lovic makes, though? I mean, he's hobbling, but he's still aware, and he gets his stick on the play right in front of the net.
And he is crawling, literally gets to the bench. Great job by the captain. You talk about leading by example. Has the back pass in tight. Rosen can't click it and convert. Rosen finds the puck, gets it in for Strömberg. Strömgren in the corner, pops free Asa. Strömgren killing off more time, just over 6 minutes remaining in this third period. Strömgren, high wrister, was hoping for a tip from Asa, didn't get it. Aho's in deep. Aho takes it around the net. Salomonsson waits, wrister tipped, and a good tip, just went wide, didn't get through to Leskis. Both sides have been out there a long time on this shift. And that'll be just hitting the top of the glass down the ice. And late icing, but it's icing, so Latvia's got to stay out there. And there's a look at the captain.
Yeah, it is icing. But because they're tired, they couldn't skate any faster. But here's the play. He blocks the shot, comes right through here. But then he gets up, he's looking around, he gets his stick, understands where the challenge is. Picks up the stick.
So Latvia calling a timeout, and there is Martin Lovic, whose father, Bud Riegel, he played in 12 IIHF World Championships for Latvia, three winter games as well. Also the Vancouver Games his dad played in 2010. His father played in the ECHL back in the day, and you know, you love these careers, Tallahassee and Raleigh. I remember the IHL, the Las Vegas Thunder. I covered the IHL as a youngster in Winnipeg, the Manitoba Moose back in the day.
And here's the play by the captain again. He blocks the shot. And there he is. He's in pain. He loses his stick, but he gathers himself. He looks around. He gets his back up on his feet, gets his stick, and then he realizes, oh, there's a chance here. Great awareness and obviously wobbling to the bench and getting off the ice. But it's amazing. You know, you're dealing with the pain of a shot block, gather yourself, and yet you're so dialed in competitively and your awareness is so good that now you break up a potential scoring chance. He's been really good in this game.
And he'll take a spot beside his teammates on the bench. Well-deserved drink of water. Matthias Havlin, good job using his speed. He closed down his man and took it away from Kristinge. Kristinge diving to get back as Dover Nielsen brings it up the left side. Tried the centering pass, knocked down in front, didn't get through. Dover Nielsen for Lucel. Lucel lost the puck and it pops back to neutral ice, so Havlin will have to reset for Sweden. 5 minutes, 10 seconds remaining. Lucel, a little bit of space, flips in the backhand, and alertly the paddle of lifts. Guess he chipped it to the far boards.
I would have liked to have seen Lucel shoot that. Nice little play coming into the zone by Matthias Havlid to free him up there. You know, you try to make that little play through the middle like he did on the backhand. Right there, he's a good shooter. He's got good hands. He can be accurate on the backhand or the forehand. Don't use those skills. He's trying to look for his teammate for the hat trick. I get what he's trying to do in a 5-0 game, but you talk about
Ravinskis right in front, dangerous spot, he falls.
Goal scorers, right? Like, you know, when you talk to anybody that's been a great goal scorer, Ray Ferraro, top 100 goal scorers all time in the NHL, he says when he was scoring, he never thought he wouldn't score. And when he wasn't scoring, he didn't think he'd ever score again. So that, you know, we talk about feel good about yourself, it really does apply to goal scorers.
So Sweden looking to put the wraps. Final game of their group play. And pick up another 3 points, up 5-0, late stages of this hockey game. Weird bounces, Havlid made the stop. Kind of fooled Hugo a little bit. And then first it takes the body check, but gets it to Sundin. Try to make moves, drive in. And Lipskis out of his net, using his stick to knock it out of harm's way.
That was the Latvian captain again, making the body check on Pearson.
Sundin, a late check on him. Lovic to the bench, they had a little conversation, then go their separate ways. Simon Aho, Forsmark. He'll dump it in. Strömgren chips it high, and that caught the netting, so it's out of play for a stoppage. With 3 minutes, 9 seconds remaining. As the Belarusians have arrived, they're going to take on Team Canada. As that is our next game at the Under-18 World Hockey Championship right here on TSN later tonight.
Chevrolet Equinox at our price. See your dealer or Chevrolet.ca for details.
We knew offensively that Latvia would be in tough in this hockey game. It was one of our storylines off the top of the show. As in each one of their losses, they managed 2 goals. Couldn't get one, at least not yet, by Hugo Havlid. They got 3 minutes and 2 seconds remaining to try break the shutout for the young netminder. Pass able to chip it up the ice. Strömgren takes the pass up the left wing. Strömgren tries to center right in front. Hasse was there. Forsmark at the blue line. He'll hesitate. Shoot up high. Deflected. Scores! As Forsmark, the initial shot looked to be redirected in front. And it's 6-0 Sweden.
Isaac Rosen, who's had a number of really, really good looks post, but he finds a way to get his stick on this one off the shot by Forsmark right through. There it is, deflects it right down. Really no chance for Lipsticks. But Forsmark finds a way to get that puck through, and there it is, straight down. Great eye-hand coordination by Isaac Rosen. Latvia can't clear, and Forsmark's totally ready. Take a little step to his left. Put your hands on your hips.
His father, Roger, played in a couple of IIHF World Juniors, winning two silvers back in the early 90s. And now Isaac representing Sweden at this year's Under-18 World Hockey Championship. Nice deflection in front. 6-0 Sweden as Silkos drops it off. Ravinskis in front, tried the backdoor pass. And Leuchtmills could not finish, and Havlid finds it, and he will hold.
Lodas came right in there and loaded up with the shot, and Havlid had to be really, really on his mark to make that save. You know, you look at a game, it was 6-0, right? Oh, how good did the goalie have to be? Really good. He had to be really good, and he was really good. Based on what I've seen of the three goalies going to the quarterfinal, that's the guy I'd start in the quarterfinal on Monday, is Havlid.
And that is a young man making his tournament debut, his first major international tournament for Sweden. Robertson pass bouncing over his stick. Pumals. And he will bring it in, a step offside. Wow, behind the play, it's Robertson getting tangled up, and Lovic, who has been into this game. I mean, he's been all over. His fingerprints are on it, working hard, blocking shots, getting physical, and him and Robertson, that was behind the play.
And I'm just gonna send both of them, I think, to their respective dressing rooms. Lovac is going there. I think Robertson will be directed to the door that leads to the dressing room. Two goals for him. Come together along the boards, little push, little shove, cross check, another cross check, swing. Get him into the octagon. There's gotta be some UFC 297 or something tonight, doesn't there? There is every Saturday. I mean, I don't know, what are they up to, 397?
Listen, I'm going to the horse show after this. That's where I'm heading. As Sweden and head coach Anders Eriksson, his workhorse has been Hugo Havlid, who has made some nice stops. He has been sharp for Sweden.
Do you know those little horses, those painted horses they have in Sweden? Have you ever seen them?
I don't think I have, no.
Oh, they're painted, and they have different sizes, and they're called Dalahasse, which is the doll horse, the horse doll. Maybe they'll give one to Simon Robertson tonight.
I thought you were offering me one. We were in Sweden together in 2019.
I have a whole bunch because I've been there dozens and dozens of times. So there comes a point in time when you don't need any more Dalahessens. It's not like I can go ride them on the ranch. There's Bob Murray, the general manager of the Anaheim Ducks. And they had a high draft pick last year with Jamie Drysdale, who's already played games. Played in this tournament in Sweden, Brian, for Team Canada as a 17-year-old player. And Bob trying to keep his eye on some of the top talent, because Anaheim's going to be picking high in the 2021 draft.
Off the draw, Forsmark towards the net, shot. Still loose, no whistle. Rapp try side of the net. It was to the left of Lipskis. Sweden still controls. Again, scramble right in the slot area. Forsmark gets the pass back to the point. He shoots high and missed. Simon Aho was actually, pardon me, that was an Aho, that was Moberg in front providing the screen. Ravinskis had a few chances offensively, centering pass in front from Giunskis, and that was picked off. Person up the left wing. Person, Greg moves, shoots, deflected, scores! Another goal as Ludwig Person lets it fly, bit of a weird bounce, and it strikes for 7 for Sweden.
Well, when you score a goal, you're just happy. You know, Pearson zips up the ice, and it takes a really good fortunate bounce. He gets the shot off, but it kind of pops up and skips to the right of Lipskis, and just nothing you can do about that one if you're the goaltender. And the flipping out changes all kinds of direction. Spins into the net. I was going to say about Bob Murray, you know, Trevor Zegras, who was the MVP of the World Junior Tournament, and he was just absolutely phenomenal in that tournament, and such a big part of the Anaheim Ducks' future, along with Jamie Drysdale. They have a really good young group of prospects, and they're going to be able to add another player in the first round from this year's draft.
Kulmoff to the forehand, tries to tuck it in. It was loose behind the pads of Haviland. And if there's one guy that deserves a goal in this game with his play, is Petter Pulmals, really driving play offensively, but again, just can't finish.
Yeah, he's been really good, really strong and assertive. You know, I think, you know, just going back to that tournament in Sweden, watching that two better national team development program than the 2001 group, and I've seen every iteration of that program since day one. I never thought that that team could lose. I thought for sure you want to start figuring out who the gold medalist is. For me, it was easy. So let's figure out who the second and third place finishers will be. Zegras, Cole Caulfield, Jack Hughes, they're all part of that group. They're devastated after losing that semifinal shootout to Russia. But they certainly redeemed themselves winning gold in Canada for Team USA at the World Junior Tournament. Such a gifted group of players. Cole Caulfield, the Hobie Baker Winner Award this year. I mean, let's go look at the accomplishments of those guys.
Just a few seconds remaining in this hockey game. 15 seconds in the third, dominated by Sweden. Moberg towards the net, side of the net, puck released. And Latvia content to flip it down the ice. Kind of held up just to put the wraps on this game as Vinenko was streaking in. That'll do it. A 7-0 win for Sweden as they wrap up group play. And the shutout in his tournament debut for Hugo Haviland.
Yeah, good. I mean, Hugo Haviland was good. The game turned, right? It turned on that 5-minute major. It was close at that point in time, and Latvia couldn't get past it.